The following was recorded during a live Q&A session following Arnold's webinar, Optimizing Induction and Permanent Magnet Motor Design for Manufacturing. You can find the link to the full presentation, including 30 minutes of in-depth Q&A just like this, in the video description below.
How is magnetization of blocks controlled? And in parentheses, how do you ensure the entitled BR is achieved uniformly at the block level before motor assembly when the BEMF is measured?
Yeah, that's a fun question. So the magnet manufacturing, I guess I'll go through a little bit the high level of the magnet manufacturing process. So a lot of what we do is, and I like to use the term blocks, a lot of what we do is we make blocks from our facility in Lupig, or we source blocks from a Chinese manufacturer, you know, a licensed Chinese manufacturer, and we bring that block to one of our magnet facilities, and then we cut that block up into our final shapes. But the blocks, basically we take blended alloys, you know, samarium and cobalt or neo and prazo, et cetera. You take a blended alloy, you jet or ball mill that alloy down to as small of a grain size as you can, usually like 1 to 5 micron size. We take that milled alloy, we put it inside of a press. It's a mechanical press, and inside that mechanical press, as we're applying a mechanical force to crush all those grains together, we also have a big magnetizing coil around the press, which aligns all the grain boundaries. So that's how you get an anisotropic magnet orientation, so all the grains are aligned in a single direction. After they come out of the press, they're what we call a green block at that point, so they're not fully dense, but they are, you know, they're pretty tough after all the sand gets pressed together. Then that goes through a sintering and tempering operation. During that operation, all the sand, you know, is fused together overall, and then you get a block out of that process. And that block, the uniformity of the block, all those grains, is really controlled by how well of a press you've designed and how good of a press you have. So you got to have, again, a nice, strong, uniform pattern for the press overall. And then you kind of go from there. Now, when we cut the magnet up, we cut every magnet up to say you're making just little rectangles. We'll cut the block down to little rectangles. Then we put it inside of a magnetizer, and that comes back to my point, is you want to magnetize with about two times the coercivity, the intrinsic coercivity, so two times HCI. And then as long as you have enough field, you orient, you fully saturate and orient that magnet completely, and it's very uniform from that standpoint. And then we check the magnets lastly inside of what we call a Helmholtz coil, which is an open circuit check of the total magnetic flux output from each individual magnet. And that's how we check our magnets before we put them on and build them onto rotors. And obviously then you get to your back EMF testing, which is the last part of your question. So that's kind of the process start to finish, and they're really uniformly controlled throughout the block.